Okay, Ossie, I remember speaking to Keith Birkinshaw last summer. That was 35 years since we managed to sign yourself and Ricky. That time's flown by, hasn't it, Ossie?
Certainly, yes. That was we started in 1978. We arrived here with Ricky, and for us it was a kind of adventure. Going to a new country right now is, of course, it's a lot of it's a lot easier right now. It's a lot of foreigner people and so on. But at the time, it was pretty decision to make. And we took it, and it was a great adventure, and we never regretted one at all. It was so nice. Right from the beginning, we were in the heart of the Tottenham people, and suddenly when the results started to come as well, it was great.
I mean, obviously you were successful as well, but there was a 10-year bond in the end as a player, wasn't there, Ossie? I mean, that was from when you first came in 78, that I mean, as an adventure, 10 years.
Yes, after that 10 years, after that I was manager as well, so I spent a very, very important part of my life here. And always have been a big connection with the club. I always say that in England, my second home was always Tottenham. So every time I come here, I feel very, very good. I feel like I am in family. So it has been a great time.
Just looking, we know you won the FA Cup. We know all about how many times you played here. Great player here, Ossie, obviously. But I want to ask you about the 83-84. season, which is obviously a 30-year anniversary of when we won the UEFA Cup. Now, we played Dnipro in the Europa League soon. At about this stage in that competition, on your way to winning it, you were playing Austria Vienna and you scored. I think Alan Brazil and Steve Archibald scored, and Alan Brazil and you scored in the second leg. What do you remember about the run? It was such a fantastic run, that wasn't it, to the UEFA Cup?
It was a great run. I mean, full great to Keith Birkinshaw. We have a lot of injuries all the time, Glenn, myself. In fact, for this game, I was coming back from injury as well. So to come back and play, I played my first game, play 90 minutes, feel good, and score a goal was the icing on the cake as well. So then we started to believe very, very strongly that we have a big chance to leave the cup. And this is what happened at the end. It was, we played a lot of very, very difficult teams, like people like Bayern Munich, people Bayern Munich, Ajax, and so on. So, well, in fact, we have a very good team. But what I remember basically, and most than anything else, is the amount of injuries that we have at the time. It was all the time, it was a new team. But everybody responded.
The great European nights here at the stadium started in 61-62 season, after we won the title in the European Cup. It's always been something under the lights here at White Hart Lane. It's always been something special. You're part of that, Ossie. What was it like in your era to play in those European games?
It was absolutely brilliant. I have to say, every game in White Hart Lane, I don't know why, but every game, maybe because the Saturday game, they were the normal thing. Every game playing at night here, Tuesday night or Wednesday night, were very, very special. It could be the FA Cup or the Milk Cup or whatever. Very, very special. But when it was the European Cup, it was even more special because the team that we were playing, they play in a different way. The English team, more or less, you know what to expect and so on. But at the time, you don't have a lot of information about the other team, even people like Real Madrid or Bayern Munich and so on. So it was all a new thing, so a novelty. So it was great. And the atmosphere here in White Hart Lane in Tuesday night, Wednesday night, it was just fantastic.
Of course, you went on to win it. It's a famous night here in the second leg when Tony Parks saved the penalty up there. I mean, what do you remember about the final, over two legs against Anderlecht and obviously lifting the trophy at the end of it? And it goes down in history of one of the special nights here, doesn't it?
It was a very, very special night for everything that happened. It was Glenn Hoddle was injured. Steve Perryman was suspended for the first because too many yellow cards, so he didn't play the second game. In the second game, I remember two or three days later, Keith Birkinshaw had to make a decision who to play. We needed somebody in midfield, so basically it was between Gary Mauer and me. And in fact, the decision was who was a little bit better. I was probably 30-40%, no more than that, to fit. I was no chance I was going to play 90 minutes, no Mapsi as well. So at the end of the day, Keith decided to go with Gary Mauer to start and me coming later on. But even though it was a big question mark about me personally, because he thought that I couldn't play. In fact, I thought I couldn't play as well. But it was a final, so we had to take a chance, and at the end of the day, Tony Park, Ray Clement was injured as well, so many, many injuries. Mickey Asa had a super game that night, and at the end of the day, we lead the cup.
It's incredible scenes. Now, of course, we're in the Europa League, we're in the round of 32, we're in the knockout stage now, Dnipro are next. What do you think of this team's chances to go on and hopefully emulate what you did 30 years ago? Obviously, now the Champions League teams are in it, so it becomes tougher, but there's a chance there, isn't there?
It's certainly a chance, yes. Well, it's everything to play for. Why not? It's a huge competition. It's not easy to win at all. It's so many games you have to play and win it. You have to advance to the next round. So the only thing that you can do is concentrate in the next game. So I'm sure this is what the boys are going to do, and win the next game and see what happens at the end of the day.